Hello, good morning students. Today we will understand how to prepare 0.1 molar oxalic acid solution. As you all know, our first experiment. In our first experiment, we will need 0.1 molar oxalic acid solution to titrate it against unknown molarity of KMnO4 solution. For the experiment, we will need some basic things. First, this is the weighing balance you need for the exact measurement of oxalic acid mass. Next, oxalic acid powder, conical flask for preparation of solution, watch glass to carry the powder, glass rod to stir the solution, spatula to put some weight, funnel, measuring cylinder to measure exact volume of oxalic acid, and distilled water. Now, first of all, we will take weighing balance and start it. Then we will place the watch glass inside it. So you can see it will measure the weight of watch glass. So we will tear it and neglect the weight of watch glass. Now we will transfer slowly 1.26 gram oxalic acid powder inside the watch glass. You know that the molecular mass of oxalic acid, that is a 126 gram. If you dissolve 126 gram oxalic acid powder inside 1000 ml, then the solution is 1 molar. But if here we need 0.1 molar oxalic acid, so in 100 ml, so we need 1.26 gram oxalic acid powder, and it will dissolve inside the 100 ml solution. Now it is 1.22, so we will slowly transfer, and small amount of powder needed for 1.26. Now it is 1.26 gram oxalic acid powder, we will remove from the weighing balance. Now we will take conical flask, which is a very clean and washed. Now put the glass funnel on it and slowly transfer the oxalic acid powder inside the funnel with the help of distilled water. We will wash the watch glass, so small particles which attached on the small watch glass, it will transfer inside the conical flask. Now you can see watch glass is clean, no particles are attached on the watch glass. Same way we will wash the funnel also with the small amount of the distilled water. Now you can see the funnel also clear. Now with the help of glass rod, we will stir the solution and mix the oxalic acid powder with the distilled water. For the exact measurement, we will take the measuring cylinder and transfer this solution inside the measuring cylinder. You can see some particles are attached on the flask, so we will wash the flask again with the distilled water. And transfer again this solution inside the measuring cylinder. Now you can see the flask also clear. Now the solution is near about 50 ml, and we need 100 ml solution. So by slowly we will transfer distilled water from the wash bottle to the measuring cylinder. Now you can see it is a 100 ml solution. We make up it. Now we will transfer the solution inside the conical flask. We will mix it properly. Now this is the solution. We called it standard with the 0.1 molar molarity. Thank you. Now to find out the molarity of Kamenofor solution, we have to do titration. For the titration, we need some basic things. You all know, burette, glass burette, conical flask for titration, funnel to transfer the Kamenofor solution, two pipettes, one is 10 ml and one is 5 ml, Kamenofor solution, 0.1 molar oxalic acid solution and dilute H2SO4. First of all, we will place the glass funnel on the burette and wash the burette with Kamenofor solution. Now we will fill the burette up to zero mark. In between, you can see the empty space on the tip of the burette. So we have to first fill it. So just one time open it and close it so it will fill. Again, we will fill the burette up to zero mark. And you must know that this is the color solution, so we have to see the lower meniscus. Now remove the funnel and it is above the zero mark, so we will make up it till it not across the zero mark. Now it is the solution is zero on the zero mark. Now we will take 0.1 molar oxalic acid solution. Okay, first of all, wash the conical flask with the oxalic acid solution. Now we will take 10 ml oxalic acid solution. Now you can see it is a 10 ml and we will transfer it in the conical flask. Now with the help of 5 ml pipette, we will take 5 ml dilute H2SO4. It is a 5 ml dilute H2SO4 for providing an acidic medium to the reaction. Now the solution need 50 to 60 degree temperature. You can see that instead of the burner we are using a gas tripod stand and wire gauze. On the wire gauze, make sure the lower surface of the flask not be wet, and transfer the flask on the flame. You have to see the small bubbles at the bottom of the flask. Now bubble is not appearing. If you can see small bubbles at the bottom side, and now it is the temperature, the flask contains 50 to 60 degree temperature, so we will put off the gas. Now you can see the fumes on the neck of the flask, so it is the right temperature to start the titration. Now we will slowly transfer drop by drop Kamenofor solution inside the flask. You can see the flask is colorless. Kamenofor solution inside the flask. You know the principle, KMnO4 is a strong oxidizing agent, so it will oxidize the oxalic acid and degrade itself, so the color of the KMnO4 is disappeared, or you can say discharged. This happened till the single oxalic acid remain inside the flask. So you have to stir the flask slowly and drop wise add KMnO4 solution. You can see still the color of solution is colorless. Now it is a 5 ml solution and our reading will be appear near about the 10 ml. So we have to add still KMnO4 solution. Here you have to take care, you shouldn't add direct 5 or 6 ml KMnO4 solution because it will hindrance the reaction. Now you can see the color of solution is changed and it remain persist. It is not disappearing. So it is our end point. And the reading of the burette is near about 12. After titration, after taking 3 consequence reading, we have to put the value inside the observation table. See, this is the observation table. Here burette reading, initial reading and final reading. So you know that our initial reading is 0 and the final reading, the color change reading, that is a 12. So the difference is 12. Consequently, you have to take 2 different reading and after that you have to take average of this 3 reading. And this is the calculation part. You know, we have to find the molarity of KMnO4 solution. So this is the molarity of KMnO4 solution formula: A1 M1 V1 is equal to A2 M2 V2. And V2 is our average reading. M1 is 0.1 molar oxalic acid solution. V1 means 10 ml oxalic acid solution. A1, 2 electron is transferring in the redox reaction. That's why I put over here 2. M2 we have to find. V2 means average volume of KMnO4 solution. I have already told you, and A2 is 5, again 5 electron is transferring in the reaction. At the end of this formula, you can find the molarity of KMnO4 solution, and the other aim is to find out the concentration of KMnO4 solution, and the concentration of KMnO4 solution, molarity into molar mass. This is the formula. Whatever you get the molarity, you have to just put down over here and multiply it with the 158, means molar mass of the KMnO4. At the end of this formula, you can get the concentration in gram per liter. And you have to just put down this value inside the molarity and concentration of KMnO4 solution. Thank you.